Today, I have the lovely and the beautiful Georgia Andriani joining us for a conversation. How are you?
I'm very well.
So for people who don't know, she is starring in a music video, which is a remixed version of Roop Tera Mastana. So, you know, I want to ask you, being part of such a cult song can be a pressure as well as an advantage because people already know the song, there's a recall value. How do you take it? Do you look at both ends of the spectrum?
Yeah, definitely it could be both, right? But I will never stop emphasizing the fact that for us, we don't imitate anybody. That is such a big part, such a big chunk of the Indian music culture that there's no way one can imitate it for sure. But what we are doing is you know, just we are just doing an homage to this song. Is we don't want to imitate anything. We just want to revive it so that in fact is loved even more. I love the old Bollywood songs. They're part of my DNA as well by now. It's just amazing, you know, how much of sexiness in Sharmila, but at the same time so much of dignity. It can be definitely portrayed just by a few people.
Not many know what all odd jobs you have done to reach where you have today. Would you like to share that with the audience?
For me, it's absolutely something that I go proud of. I don't want to hide this. But yeah, worked in restaurants for many, many years in my life. I have worked in restaurants and at the same time I was studying. So I had this job and I was taking care of my bills and paying my studies as well. So yeah, it's something that, you know what, now it's a fashionable thing, I would say, more maybe in Hollywood, maybe more than in Bollywood. In Hollywood, I would say that people start waitressing and just taking jobs just to sustain themselves. So I can proudly say that, yeah, that's what I have done for many, many years. I mean, not many, many, but maybe five years.
You know, the thing is that when you have had seen those days, like those days where you have struggled to make a living, and like you said, this has been a part of your livelihood at one point. Were there any moments of self-doubt? Were there any moments where you felt dejected or downright low?
I definitely have gone through many moments like that where I have not doubted myself, because I always was confident that slowly I would make things happen in my life. However, being in an uncomfortable situation, which is definitely, you know, working 12 hours in a day and studying and, you know, not having the time to do anything else, and definitely not having enough money to cope with the daily life. Definitely, yeah. I mean, it was hard. It was hard.
What has been Arbaaz's reaction to your song?
He loved it, because Arbaaz also is like a massive, massive fan of the old
classic
songs. In fact, in the beginning, this is also what kind of, you know, we had this thing in common. So in the beginning, when we first met, we kept sending each other the Bollywood old songs.
Oh, so cute.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you know, Arbaaz is like I feel that among all everybody in the family, I think Arbaaz is the coolest. He has a very wicked sense of humor, and he's extremely funny. What has been the most loving and most annoying thing about Arbaaz in the last 3 years that you found out about?
As you rightly said, he is funny, and I am everything but serious. As in, I love to joke. For me, waking up in the morning, like, I already need to start with the first joke. I'm a joker, let's say so. And see, with Arbaaz, it's just funny. It's just fun.
And paparazzi, like the media photographers, they have a very wicked sense of humor too. So they sometimes call you Bhabhi. Do you know, how do you react to that? And is there a plan to like settle down? I've asked this to Arbaaz also, and I want to ask you this. Is there a plan to settle down? And how do you react to people calling you Bhabhi? That's also very important.
I think it's a cute way.
Absolutely.
It's really cute. So if paps call me Bhabhi, for me, it's just a cute way. I don't know what to say.
You are cute yourself.
Huh?
You are cute yourself.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah, and of course, I mean to say, if there is ever some good news, you'll be the first I'll reveal it to.
Yeah, you have to. You don't have a choice. You have to.
No, but as of now, there's no such news. But yeah, I'll definitely let you know if. Yeah. There is.
It shows in the kind of effort that you've put in this song, and more to come. All the best. I hope this works wonders for you. Thank you for this lovely conversation. You are extremely cute.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.